So in English, it's cochineal, and in Spanish is grana cochinilla. Hi, I'm Gloria Cortina. I am a Mexican designer. I work with indigenous concepts and culture from Mexico, fusing it into contemporary design. The cochinilla comes from, it's a beetle. It's an actual insect that it's molido, and then you dilute it with different solutions and you can get different, let's say, dyes. The cochinilla is mainly found in Mexico, Central America, and Peru. And from this area of the world, it just became incredibly powerful for dyes, for artists, for even food, right? And in Mexico, grana cochinilla is a concept that we use not only in textiles, but we also, it's a very folkloric color and a very folkloric, it's part of our culture. The idea behind this map is that we wanted to capture cochinilla trails. Cochinilla trails is how the pigment went from country to country and how, for example, from America, it went into Europe and then went down to Africa. Africa came to Europe and then it went to India and all the way around. So it has a lot of tenacity. And in a way, it's a very coveted pigment. Doing this wallpaper, we worked with Holland and Sherry. The first idea that I wanted to conceive was to treat grana cochinilla as a watercolor. So we only diluted the pigment, the little bugs were crushed, you dilute it with water, and then we started working in different strokes to get to open up all the different hues that the grana has. So when we started the installation, as it's an organic material, when the glue was on the back panel and we started installing it, the grana cochinilla turned gray. And so we panicked a little bit. But there's a saying in Mexico that when something, you know, that it's foreign to the cochinilla hits the pigment, people in Mexico say that the cochinilla gets really sensitive and it starts crying. So I told all the curators, let's be patient. The weekend passed, and then suddenly the color just came back again.